Hotel. Myself, Namkit Lepcha, from Sikkim in the district of North. I'm going to recite a poem with the title, Five Rules for Whomever It May Concern. I repeat, five rules for whomever it may concern. One, do not judge me if I wear a hot pants and sleeveless top with the two pieces of clothes sliding from my shoulder to my chest, because my clothes do not define who I am. What defines me is what I do and what I am capable of. Two, do not stare at me if I have a bright colored hair on an ink body. Of course, you can look at me and appreciate the art and effort, but I do not give you the right to stare at me and make me feel uncomfortable. It is an act of bravery, bravery of being different, of being unique, of not being afraid to experiment, or not an open invitation to laugh or mock at. Three, if I wear a red cherry blossom lipsticks and smile at you, do not take it otherwise. Trust me, it's courtesy, not curiosity. I repeat, it's courtesy, not curiosity. Four, if you say sorry and I say it's okay, doesn't mean I'm okay with you hurting me. It means you do it again and you know the consequences, which brings me to five. Five, do not underestimate by seeing the size of my fist. Because when you look closely, this small fist is made of molten iron. One blow and you know you'll be slayed like my small sharp eyes. It is so sharp that it can cut you into a thousand pieces when you look at it with lust and hatred. And if you still do not obey these rules, remember, my forefathers were headhunters. I was born out of a clan of warriors. Remember, the word hottest chili is growing in my grandmother's garden. Remember the Battle of Kohima, perhaps one of the cruelest battles in the history of World War II. And yes, it was fought in my backyard. But dear, if you smile at me with love, kindness and oneness, I will be your friend. I will take you to the places where you haven't been before, from plains to mountains, rivers to valleys. I will narrate you the folk tales which were passed down to me by my grandfather and which were passed down to him by his great-great-great-grandfather. I will tell you the story of the man who turned into a flower, a baby who turned into a ladybird. I will sing you a melodious song like a bird chirping all day long. I will leave you a friendship band made of silkworm. All I ask from you is, dear, please, do not judge me on the basis of my future or of my dress. Thank you so much. Once again, good evening.